Guys, so can you please open your copybooks as usual, write today's date, classwork. And our topic today is Ukraine in the Northern War. It lasted from 1700 till 1721. As you may guess, Northern War. Why do we call it so? The battlefield, yeah, and the place of fighting was the northern part of Europe. The thing is that Russia and Sweden were fighting for the Baltic Sea. Okay? So here you can see the Tsar of Moscow, Tsar Peter I. Two pictures of him. Remember what I told you about something interesting about Peter I? That he was a friend of Hetman Ivan Mazepa. Do you remember? Actually, that was one of the reasons why Mazepa became Hetman. As you remember, I hope. And I hope you do remember, and I hope you read previous paragraph, your homework, about Mazepa and his policy. He was given lots of rights, lots of freedoms by Peter I. And as people said back to then, Peter I would not believe an angel. He would prefer to believe Mazepa. So, that's just for you to note, okay? So, guys, that battles that considered, like, to talk about Ukrainian lands, they took place in 1708. It started everything, like, connected to Ukrainian lands from 1708. Why? Because Karl the 12th, you can see him here, by the way, he led his army towards Moscow. But on his way, he decided to go through Belarus lands. He thought that would give him some benefits, it would help him. But unfortunately, due to weather conditions, due to the roads and illnesses that his soldiers got and some other issues, he had to stay on the lands controlled by Mazepa. Why, you can ask me. Guys, Mazepa decided to betray Peter I. And when people kept saying Peter I about Mazepa's plans, Peter I did not believe. He even killed some colonels, generals that told him about Mazepa's plans. So he did not believe. But Mazepa, indeed, he did it. He signed a number of agreements with Karl the 12th against Peter I. Okay, and one of the, let's say, benefits that would Karl the 12th get from this agreement was that just in case, if Karl the 12th would not be able to go immediately to Moscow or if there would be some problems, he and his troops, his army, could stay on Ukrainian lands. On the lands controlled by Mazepa, okay? And that happened. And, of course, Mazepa had to show his attitude. Yes, when Karl the 12th was coming to Ukrainian lands, Mazepa, of course, greeted him, led his soldiers to stay. But what was the problem? That most of the people, majority of society, they, like, you know, they thought that Mazepa betrayed them. They did not know about his plans, about his alliance with Karl the 12th. But they did know that they had war with Sweden. Look, you know what makes people, like, I don't know, united? What makes people connected, attached to each other? Lots of things. Yeah, you may think about friendship, about, I know, relations like relatives, but one more thing, that's like common enemy. If you have a common enemy, you would be like connected. Yes, you would fight together, you would feel that you're like, you know, like brotherhood, like you're having like brotherhood because you have common enemy. That was the case of Hetmanshchina, of people that lived there, yes, and Peter I and his Moscow Tsardom. they had the same enemy. So there was propaganda that we have great like war, we fight against enemies. So they had this, the same enemy. So they were united in that case. And they thought Mazepa just betrayed them, that he signed an agreement with an enemy. Yeah. So people did not support Mazepa and Karl the 12th, most of them, but supported Peter the First. So can you please write this? And we are going to reasons. Guys, so one of the reasons was that Swedes, they look different. You know, they had different appearance. Even you, maybe you don't realize it, but even the way they would choose, would pick their clothes, their fashion even, their appearance, like hair, that was different from them, from people that lived on Ukrainian lands. In that way, Ukrainians and Russians, yeah, they're like more, they look more similar than with Swedes, yeah? So they were seen as foreigners, and not only foreigners, but enemies, yes? Because they were in war, yes? So they were seen as enemies. They had different religion. That was also like one of the, let's say, pluses, yes, to see enemies in them. So people did not want to be influenced. Remember, they, like they were on the right bank of Ukraine, how they were influenced by Rzecz Pospolita to get Catholicism. So people did not want to, like I said, to be forced to change their religion. Okay, next, one of the reasons why people didn't support Mazepa was his social policy. Guys, I hope you do remember, I mentioned, we talked a lot about Mazepa and his policy. Look, let's like recall from our memories, yes, what we remember about achievements of National Liberation War led by Bohdan Khmelnytsky. One of the greatest achievements was that there was no slavery. Let's say peasants would be free. They would not have to go to the field to work, like as we call in Ukraine, panshina, to work on the fields of landlords. But with Mazepa coming to power, it was brought back. So let's say people hated it, yeah. And Mazepa himself was one of the biggest landlords. He had lots of villages, estates, yes, with people that were, like, in fact, his property. So he was a landlord himself. So that's why even, look, Cossacks from Zaporozhye Siege, they would call him father-in-law of Ukraine. It means, like, not native father, yes, and sometimes not native, it is believed, okay, not always, but sometimes they don't love kids as they would love their own kids, yes, fathers-in-law. So they called him father-in-law of Ukraine. One of the reasons. Next, people weren't informed. Guys, what people are afraid of the most? Of the third, yes. Of being, like, not knowing, okay, what is happening. Mazepa did not explain that he wanted to fight against Russia, yes, to get Ukrainian lands free. He did not explain it. Okay? Why? He had his reasons too. Because if he would say it, Peter the First immediately would know it. Yeah? And he decided not to do it because there was a possibility that Karl the 12th would not go here.